Heavenly Father, we thank you for our Bible study once again tonight.
Baba wa tin be lorun, a dupe lowo yin fun eko bibeli lekan si ni asale yi.
Thank you for reminding us of your love for us.
A dupe te ran wa leti nipa ife ti eni si wa.
One of the great wonders we can ever think about that you love people like us.
Iyanu nla ni ti a le ronu nipa re pe e ferin eyan bi iru ti wa yi.
Once again, Lord, we thank you, we bless your name, we exalt you. Accept our praises in Jesus' name.
Lekan si Oluwa, a fi ola fun yin, a fi iyin fun yin, a gbe yin ga. Baba gbadura pe ke gbo pe ati yin wa ni oruko Jesus.
We know that you manifest your love in various ways to us.
Amo pe orisirisi ona le ngba na wo fe yin si wa.
And we pray that we'll never fail to see your hand in our law, in our lives, showing that mercy, showing compassion, and showing love in Jesus' name.
Oluwa, angbadura pe a oni dekun lati ma ri owo yin to nawo anu ati ife yi si wa ni gbogbo igba ni oruko Jesus.
We pray that you make us to understand the depth of your love.
Baba gbadura pe ke je ki a mo ijile ife yin,
so that anything that happens will see beyond that thing and above that thing your love for our lives.
Ati pe onko to ba sele si igbe aye wa oju wa oni te mo nkan yen nikan sugba o wo kererere a o ri ife yin to fara han ninu re.
We pray that you make us to see what you have for us in your word even tonight.
Asin gbadura pe ke ran wa lowo lati ri nti eni fun wa ninu oro yin ni asale yi.
Satisfy every heart, O Lord.
Gbogbo okan ni ke te lorun Oluwa.
We pray that the things that bring confusion to our hearts, you'll so explain to us that all confusion will vanish away in Jesus' name.
Ati pe gbogbo to ti mu yin ruru ba okan wa e o salaye wo fun wa to bege to je pe gbogbo iporuru ni yo pora ni oruko Jesu.
We bless your name because we know you have answered.
Afi ibuku fun oruko yin tori pe awon pe ti da wa lohun.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
We are still continuing our study of the word of God in Hebrews chapter 12.
As in test, what you need, danileko bibeli wa ninu Hebrew ori kejila.
You will remember we spent such a long time in Hebrews chapter 11.
Wa aranti pe opolopo akoko ni abisile lati keko ninu Hebrew ori kokanla.
And as we come to chapter 12, the apostle is reminding us, we've got a cloud of witnesses and we've seen all that the Lord has done for them. Now we need to look unto Jesus.
Ati ri ninu eko ti a ti ko pe apostle n so fun wa wi pe awon eleri ti o yi wa ka bi awo somo ni ati ri a si ti ri nti olorun n se ninu aye won nipa be ohun to kan ni pe ki a wa ma wo Jesu.
And as he tells us to look at the Lord Jesus Christ, it's not just talking about one single look, because we looked at him when we came born again, but we need to continue looking at him.
Nigba to n so nipa wiwo Jesu, apostle yi o so pe ka wo lekan ka moju kuro lara re, sugbon nigba ti a ti deni igbala a lati tesi waju lati te oju wa mo ni wiwo re.
He said looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith.
O ni ki a ma wo Jesu olupilese ati alase pe igbagbo wa.
And then he tells us the example of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Nibe lo wa so fun wa nipa apere Jesu Oluwa wa.
He tells us about the cross.
O so fun wa nipa agbelebu.
About the shame he endured.
Nipa etiju to fara.
And about the joy that was set before him. And then he tells us to constantly consider the Lord Jesus Christ. He tells us something about his life in particular. He said that Jesus endured such contradiction of sinners against him. He said we are now on the battlefield. We are fighting the good fight of faith. We are resisting temptation. And there is a devil that is fighting against our progress in the Christian race. He said we should keep on resisting. He said, after all, you have not resisted unto blood. He said that there are people like Stephen. There are people that have sealed their testimony even with their blood. And if they resisted unto blood, striving against sin, he said, look at what you are doing. Keep on fighting against the devil and keep on resisting temptation until you come to the end of the journey.
He
now wants to bring exhortation to these Hebrew Christians. And this same exhortation is bringing to you and bringing to me. He wanted to bring this exhortation, not because they had not heard it before, not because they didn't know it before, but because they were forgetting. Look at it in chapter 12 verse 5. And ye have forgotten.
Ye
have forgotten. Now Paul the apostle could tell that by the way they were reacting to their problems, they had forgotten something. The problem of forgetfulness is a common problem. And many of the children of Israel in the Old Testament, they got into a lot of problems they got into because they forgot what they ought to remember. They forgot the love of God for them. They forgot the care of God for them. And every time they forgot the great things the Lord had done for them, they looked at small, small needs in their lives and they became discouraged. Forgetting the great thing made the small thing so mighty in their
sight.
And this is still true today. We forget many of the lessons we have learned already in scripture. In fact, some of the lessons we learned at home in the family and the lessons we have learned at school and the lessons we still learn in society at large. What lesson was the apostle telling them they had forgotten? Look at that in verse 5. It says, and ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. My son, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him.
Oni eyin si ti gbagbe oro eyanju tin ba yin so bi omo pe omo mi ma se alaina ni ibawi oluwa ki o ma se rewesi nigbati abanti owo re ba owi.
He was talking about the father's discipline.
O so nipa ibawi ti baba.
And he says if we forget that, then we'll have the wrong attitude to God's dealings with us.
Oni ti a ba lo gbagbe leyi a wa ni iwa to lodi si ifasepo ibasepo wa pelu Olorun.
And whenever we forget those important lessons, it will bring spiritual loss rather than spiritual gain or progress in our lives.
Nigba ki igba ti a ba padanu iru eko bayi, ohun ti yo sele si wa ni pe ipadanu emi yo wa dipo ilosiwaju nipa ti emi.
When you do not see the love of God in God's dealings with you,
nigba ti o ba ri ife Olorun ninu ibasepo Olorun si o,
everything the Lord wants you to be partakers of, you will miss and you will lose.
Gbogbo ti Olorun ba fe ki o je alabapin ninu re, gbogbo re pata ni wa padanu re.
And the subject of divine discipline taught in these verses that we're studying today normally should bring joy, should bring assurance, should bring encouragement to the believer's heart.
Oye ki o je ohun ayo ìdániloju àti ìmúlọ́kàn lè bá ọkàn àwa onígbàgbọ́.
We will know it is for our profit when we have done something wrong and the Lord rebukes us.
A o mọ pe fun ire wa ni nigba ti a ba se nto lodi ti Oluwa ba ba wa wi.
Discipline children eventually will become useful and will become the joy of the family.
Àwọn ọmọ tí a bá ń bá wí lọ́jọ́ iwájú wọn ó wúlò, wọn ó sì di ayọ̀ fún ẹbí.
And so as we look at the subject, there is an attitude the Lord wants us to have.
Nítorí náà bí a ṣe ń wo ẹ̀kọ́ yìí, ìwà kan sí ń bẹ tí Ọlọ́run retí pé kí a ní.
Ephesians chapter 5 verse 20.
Éfésù orí karùn-ún ẹsẹ̀ ogún.
Ephesians 5 verse 20.
Éfésù orí karùn-ún ẹsẹ̀ ogún.
Giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Ẹ máa dúpẹ́ nígbà gbogbo fún ohun gbogbo lọ́wọ́ Ọlọ́run.
That's what the apostle wanted to see in the lives of the Hebrews. He wanted them to understand all things work together for good unto them that love the Lord, unto them that are called according to his purpose. And he wanted them to be thanking the Lord for the rain and for the sunshine. And for everything that happened in their lives, he wanted them to see the love of God behind every event of their lives. And when they were not manifesting that trust attitude, he said, you Christians, you are forgetting the exhortation that the Lord had given unto you. Because of that now, he gives us real exhortation, real understanding concerning divine discipline. I pray the Lord will open our eyes to see that we will know the purpose of the Father's discipline in our lives. The study is divided into three parts. Number one, precept and practice of divine discipline. Number two, parental example of discipline. And then number three is profit in divine discipline. Let's look first of all at the precept and the practice. Hebrews chapter 12, we're looking at it from verse 5 again. And ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. My son, despise not the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him.
Ẹ̀yin sì ti gbàgbé ọ̀rọ̀ ìyànjú tí ń bá yín sọ bí ọmọ pé, ọmọ mi, má ṣe aláìná ní ìbáwí Olúwa.
You see, he's quoting scripture here. And he says, my son, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord, neither should you faint when you are rebuked of him. And he was also rebuking them because they had forgotten that scripture. From where did he quote that scripture? It's in Proverbs chapter 3 from verse 11. Proverbs chapter 3 verse 11 and verse 12. My son, despise not the chastening of the Lord, neither be weary of his correction. For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth, even as a father the son who in whom he delighteth. Now if you have read the book of the Proverbs before, you will see that there is a law of instruction for sons, and it says my son many times in the book of Proverbs. And you will see the necessity of correction for children at home if you have read the book of Proverbs.
And
then he's bringing what happens in the family, he brings that to the family of God.
He said, as
the father is a picture of God in the family, and he disciplines children, he corrects children in the family, even so the heavenly father in his own family, spiritual family, he corrects his own children.
Oni gaga bi baba ninu ile to duro gaga bi Olorun gaga bi awon baba yi ti ma nba awon omo won wi ninu ile be ni Olorun Olorun to je baba fun ijo ati awon omo ti re o ma nba won wi.
And he says in this verse 11, my son, despise not the chastening of the Lord.
Ni ese kokanla yi lo wa wi pe omo mi ma se ko iba wi Oluwa.
Neither be weary of his correction.
Be ni ki agara itoni re ki o ma se da.
He now tells us there is love behind that correction.
O wa fi ye wa pe ife wa laarin iba wi yen.
There is a compassion of the father, the mercy of the father, the good nature of the father, and the project, the plan, the desire of the father behind that correction of the child.
Oni ikanu baba anu ati yonu baba ilepa fun ojo iwaju ti baba fun omo yi o nbe laarin gbogbo ibawi to nbo omo yi wi.
For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth.
Nitori pe eni ti Oluwa fe ohun ni to.
Even as a father the son in whom he delighted.
Gege bi baba ti to omo ti inu re do si.
Please come back to Hebrews chapter 12. And I want you to notice something in verse 5. Because this is the study of the Bible. Come back to Hebrews chapter 12 verse 5. And ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh. Now can you see the tense there? Speaketh is in the present tense. And see what he's quoting. He's quoting from Proverbs, and Proverbs have been written more than 1,000 years before the time the apostle was writing.
And
he's telling us that the Old Testament is still speaking today unto the church. That the Old Testament is not archaic. The Old Testament is not to be forgotten. The Old Testament is not to be abandoned. In fact, the exhortation of the Old Testament is speakers even today.
And then
you say, he said, ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you.
Oni eyin si ti gbagbe oro iyanju ti o nba yin so.
You see the people that do not understand the word of God, they will say the old covenant is abolished, the old covenant is abandoned, therefore all the words of the Old Testament, they are no more useful to us today.
Awon ti won loye oro Olorun se ni wa ma papa janu won ma so fun e wi pe majemu lai lai o ti dohun igbagbe ati kan sile ati rekoja re bayi.
And you know that the apostle had emphasized the abolishment or the cancellation of the old covenant.
O si mo pe apostle yi gan o ti fenu ba nipa ti majemu lai lai ti apare.
But you see, he was telling us that is the animal sacrifice that had been abandoned, is the animal sacrifice that is cancelled, but the exhortation, the commandment, the righteous principles in the Old Testament, they are still speaking to us today. In fact, he said, you Hebrew Christians, you know your problem, you know why you are getting discouraged, you know why you are not strong in the faith, it's because you have forgotten the exhortation which is still speaking unto you today as unto the children of God.
Kama rubo yen gbogbo ti majemu lalai ki a fi agota tabi orisirisi nkan rubo iyen ti re koja sugbon awon oro iyanju awon ase awon igbe aye ododo ti a ko sinu majemu lalai o sin sise titi di oni oloni o ti le so fun awon ara eberu pe e ma idi wahala yin ati iyonu ti en ni ohun to fa ni pe awon oro iyanju ti a ti ko saaju e ma ngbagbe won.
Now he talks about that divine discipline in that verse 5.
Ni ese ikarun lo wa so nipa ibawi lati oke wa.
He said, my son, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him.
Oni omo mi Masi alai ni ibawi oluwa. Masi alai na ni ibawi oluwa. Ki o masi sere wesi. Nigba ti abanti owo re ba owi.
There are two attitudes he's telling us to manifest under discipline.
Iwa meji lo n fi han wa pe ki a fi han ni akoko ibawi.
We're talking of discipline here. We're talking of the rebuke of the Lord himself.
Nigba ti a ba nso nipa ibawi ni yi, a nso nipa ibawi lati odo Olorun funra
re. We're talking about the Lord himself directly rebuking us, directly correcting us, or maybe he can use something or he can use someone in correcting us.
Ti a ba nso nipa ibawi ni yi, a nso nipa pe ki Olorun Olodumara Olodumare funra re ko ma ba wa wi tarata tabi ko lo nkan tabi ki o lu enikan lati ba wa wi.
Whether it's rebuking you directly or it's rebuking you using something or rebuking you using someone, it says you must not despair and you must not despise.
O ni nigba ki igba ti Olorun boya funra re lo n ba o wi tabi o lo nkan tabi o nlo eniyan kan lati ba owi o ni niru akoko be ma se rewesi be ni ko ma se
kedo. Number one, it says my son despise not.
O ni lakoko omo mi ma se alaina ni
ibaruwa. He's telling you something there. When the rebuke of the Lord comes, you will not despise it.
O so nkan kan fun oni pe nigbati ibawi Olorun ba wa sodo re ki o ma se alaina ni.
How do people despise the correction of the Lord, the discipline of the Lord?
Bawo ni awon eniyan se ma se alaina ni.
Number one, by callousness, that is the hardness of heart. They become callous, they become hardened, they have a I don't care attitude. By callousness, they despise the chastening rod of the Lord.
Ki o dabi eni pe oro yen ko do mo won ninu won dabi eni pe won binu si ibawi Olorun yi
nigba to ron baba won complaining.
Ekeji ni nipa sisi awawi,
they will be complaining against God.
Won ma si awawi si Olorun.
Oh God, why?
Olorun ki lo de?
Why have you done this to me?
Ese to se sele fun mi.
Check up, check up. Do not despise the chastening rod of the Lord.
Iwo wa di re wo dada, ma si alaina ni ibawi Olorun.
Number three is by criticism.
Eketa ni pe
the Lord may use any of his servants, the Lord may use any of his people, and he rebukes me and he rebukes you, and then we begin to criticize the instrument, not knowing that that rebuke is coming from the Lord himself.
Olorun le faaye gba iranse re tabi enikeni lati ba mi wi lati ba o wi sugbon ni eyin ibawi yi kin wa ma si atako tabi kin ma so rodi si irinse ti Olorun lo lati ba mi wi.
Number four is by carelessness.
Ekerin nipa iwa ijafara.
Oh, we become careless and carefree.
Igba yen wa wa di alafara iwa kokan mi.
Well, the Lord said I'm not doing it all right.
Oluwa so pe n o se se na dada.
He says I cannot handle what he had told me to handle before.
N to fi le mi lowo pe kin se o ti ni n o le se tele.
That's all right, that just makes me free, and it means I cannot spend my time the way I want. Instead of spending the time and reading the word of God and praying, they manifest carefree, careless attitude.
If you look at the end of verse 5, it says
nor faint when thou art rebuked of him.
Báwo ìlà tó gbẹ̀yìn ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkarun yẹn ó ní tàbí kí o má se rẹ̀wẹ̀sì nígbà tí a bá ń ti ọwọ́ rẹ̀
bọ́. The other side is coming into despair.
Ìgbà ìhà kejì ni pé kí ènìyàn wá sọ ìrètí nù.
That means then, number one, there is discouragement.
Ìyẹn ó wá túmọ̀ sí nígbà náà ni pé ìsọ̀rètí nù àwà.
You will see when some people, when they have discipline from the Lord, when they have correction from the Lord, instead of picking up and saying, oh, praise the Lord, I'm a child of God, I'm a member of the family of God, the Lord is manifesting his love to me, that is why he's correcting me, they don't have that positive attitude, that good attitude. They faint in their mind, they are despondent in their mind. Well, it means I'm not a child of God, it means I'm not doing well, it means God doesn't want me in his kingdom. Do not faint when you are rebuked of him.
Eti won iba fi ni iwa si rere pe ope ni fun Olorun iyan ni pe Olorun si ka mi kun awon omo re tori be lo se n ba mi wi ki won si ma fi ogbo ati iyin fun Olorun ni akoko ibawi yen wa wa kawo gbera wa so ireti nu wa ne o tun mo si pe olorun feran mi niyan n o si lara omo re nitori na wa so fun e pe ki iwo ki o ma se rewe si nigba ti a ba nti owo re ba o.
So number 1 is discouragement, number 2 is double mindedness.
Akoko ninu re ni idayafo ekeji ni iye meji.
They become double minded in prayer, double minded in holding on to the promise of God, double minded in settling that thing, and they feel that, well, I don't know whether God loves me or not, whether I will accept me or not, whether the kingdom of God is still for me or not. They become double minded and they lose their faith in the Lord.
Iye meji awa gbokan won kan ni akoko la akoko adura won ma si iye meji ni wiwaju oluwa ni wiwa oju oluwa won ma si iye meji won ma ro ni danu ara won pe ngba ti olorun le ba mi wi bayi ti won ba ti egbadura mi o mo boya yo gba mi pada sinu ijoba re mo o wa so pe ki o ma se rewe sinu okan.
Number 3 is depression or dejection.
Eketa o ni pe ki kare okan ko
they become so depressed and they think now they are the most miserable person on earth. See what has happened to me, see the way the Lord is correcting me, and then there is depression or dejection.
Ikari okan wahala na wa mu won lomi iyan ni pe wa ma ro ninu ara won pe ko si ona abayo mo wa ni ikari okan.
Number 4, desertion. They feel that, well, since I'm rebuked like that, I'm corrected like that, they faint to the point, instead of moving forward, instead of holding on to their post, they even desert the Lord and they go away completely, instead of that point, that chastisement or discipline making them better in the kingdom of God, it actually makes them to desert the kingdom of God.
Wọ́n kúrò lọ́dọ̀ ọlọ́run nírú àkókò yẹn tó yẹ kí ìbáwí tí ọlọ́run bá wọn wí yẹn kó jẹ́ kí wọ́n gba ìpèníjà láti túbọ̀ súnmọ́ ọlọ́run sí ní irú àkókò bẹ́ẹ̀ ìkáàrí ọkàn yìí á wá mú wọn fa ara wọn sẹ́yìn lọ́dọ̀ olúwa.
And that is what Paul the apostle observed in the lives of the Hebrew Christians, that they were forgetting that exhortation, therefore they were coming into despair and they were coming into despising the chastising of the Lord.
Nìdí ni ti Paul apostle nígbà tí ó ṣàkíyèsí lẹ́yìn nínú ayé àwọn ara Hebrew, o wa so fun won wi pe dipo ti won e ba fi gba ibawi oluwa yi won wa gba ayirewesin ni okan won wa nko ina won na ni ibawi oluwa.
For the exhortation of the Lord is to tell us that divine discipline is not something we should misinterpret. In fact, we should be happy. It's because the Lord is counting you as part of his family. That's why he corrects you when you go wrong.
Ihun ti oluwa wa so fun wa ni wi pe nigba ti a ba ni ibawi lati oke wa lati odo olorun eleyi ko ye ki a ni iwasi ti o lodi sugbon ki a lo ibawi yi lati layo lati tubo sin oluwa si.
In Job chapter 5 verse 17,
Job ori karun ese iketanilogun,
behold, happy is the man whom the Lord corrects. You see that? It's counting you as his child. It's counting you a member of the family. Therefore, you are blessed. You are happy when the Lord corrects you.
Nitori na nigba ki igba ti Oluwa nba ba o wi eni ibukun ni o ti di alayo
ni. It says in that verse 17, therefore despise not thou the chastening of the Almighty.
Ni ese iketadinlogun yi lo tun wa tenumo wi pe nitori na ni ma se gan ibawi Olodumare.
I'm sure you know that God loved David in the Old Testament.
Mo da mi loju wi pe o mo pe Olorun feran David nu majemu
la. In fact, he referred to him as a man after his own heart.
O ti en toka si
and he made a covenant with him. He was going to bless him, he was going to use him, he was even going to use his children. But see what the Lord told him in Psalm 89. Psalm 89 from verse 30. If his children forsake my law and walk not in my judgments,
bi awon mo re ba ko ofin mi sile ti won ko si rin nipa idajo mi,
if they break my statutes and keep not my commandments,
bi won ba ba ilana mi je ti won ko si pa ofin mi mo,
then I will visit their transgression with the rod and their iniquity with stripes.
Nigba na ni emi o fi ogo be irekoja won wo ati ese won pelu ina.
You see, that's the love of God. Saying that if your children, if they do not follow after my ways, if they do not keep my commandments, I will not want them to die in sin. I will not want them to perish in their evil. Because of that, I will chastise them. I will discipline them so that that discipline will make them to think of their ways and come back to the law.
Ti won ko rin ninu ilana won ti won pa ofin won mo ti won ko rin ninu ife ti ohun olorun fi han won nigba na ohun olorun o ni fe aye gba won lati ku sinu ipada seyin tabi ninu ese na ohun yo wa lo ogbo ibawi lati ba won wi ki won ki o ba le pada si ona won.
I will visit their transgression with the rod.
O ni nigba na ni emi o fi ogbo be ire koja won
o. That is talking about chastisement, that is talking about divine discipline.
Ele nso nipa ina tabi ibawi lati orun wa.
If any time you do something wrong, if there is any time you do something which is not according to the will of God, if you have been a child of God in reality and the Lord counts you as a part of his family, the Lord will rebuke you. He will apply the rod of correction. What is to be the attitude of a child of God to that rod of correction? Micah chapter 6 verse 9. The Lord's voice cries unto the city, and the man of wisdom shall see thy name. Hear ye the rod, and who has appointed it?
Oh, Oluwa ki gbesi ilu na ọlọgbọn yóò sì rí orúkọ rẹ̀ ẹgbọ́ ọ̀pá náà àti ẹni tí ó yàn.
The rod has a message. Hear ye the rod.
Ọ̀pá náà tàbí ọ̀gọ́ náà ó ní ọ̀rọ̀ kan láti sọ ní gbọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ̀.
The rod has been sent from the Almighty God to tell you something that you have forgotten, to give you an exhortation that you have forgotten. Hear ye the rod.
Ọ̀gbọ́ tí Ọlọ́run lò tàbí ọ̀pá tí Ọlọ́run lò láti bá ọ wí, ó ní nǹkan kan tí ó fẹ́ láti sọ fún ọ, ó ní gbọ́ ọ̀pá náà.
He said, but look beyond the rod and think about who has appointed the rod.
Ó wá ní gbójú rẹ kọjá ti ọ̀pá tó ń rí, ó ní kí o wá wo ẹni tí ó yàn.
That means then, I am not to be complaining, you are not to be complaining.
Ìyẹn wá túmọ̀ sí pé èmi ò yẹ kí n máa ṣàwáwí, bẹ́ẹ̀ ni ìwọ ò ní láti ṣàwáwí.
It means we are not to be criticizing the instrument of the rod. We should look beyond that rod and see who has appointed that role.
Ìyẹn ni pé kò dára nígbà náà ká máa kùn tàbí ká máa ṣàwáwí sí orin iṣẹ́ tí Ọlọ́run lò tí sí ọ̀pá yìí, ṣùgbọ́n kí á wò rí kọjá rẹ̀.
In Lamentation chapter 3.
Ẹkún Jeremiah orí kẹta.
Lamentation chapter 3 verse 39.
Ẹkún Jeremiah orí kẹta ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkàndínlógójì.
Wherefore does a living man complain, a man for the punishment of his sins?
Èsè tí ènìyàn àlàyé ń kún tí ó wà láàyè.
You see, he's telling us that if the rod has been appointed, if the discipline has come, if the chastisement has come, if there's correction or reproof or rebuke, why should a living man complain, a man for the punishment of his sins?
O wa so gbangba pe ti opa na ba yo si o tabi ta ba na wa ibawo si o ti Olorun lo rin se kan lati fi to eso na o ni èsè tí ènìyàn láàyè ń kún tí ó wà láàyè kí olúkúlùkù kí ó kàn nítorí ẹsẹ̀ rẹ̀.
Look at it now in verse 40. It says, let us search and try our ways and turn again to the Lord.
Wá wo ẹsẹ̀ ogójì báyìí, ó ní jẹ́ kí á wádìí, kí á sì dán ọ̀nà wa wò, kí á sì tún yí padà sí Olúwa.
Let us lift up our heart with our hands unto God in the heavens.
Jẹ́ kí a gbé ọkàn àti ọwọ́ wa sókè sí Ọlọ́run ní ọ̀run.
You see, that's the attitude we ought to have whenever there is any correction.
Eléyìí gan ló yẹ kó jẹ́ ìwàsí wa nígbàkigbà tí a bá ń bá wa wí.
Instead of complaining, instead of criticizing, instead of deserting the Lord, instead of running away from the church, we will hear the rod, we will know that that rod is giving us a message, and we will go to the Lord and turn to the Lord and repent of our evil ways.
tabi ki a fi ijo sile tabi ki a ko olorun sile ni akoko ibawi yi se lo ye ki a ni iwa daradara lati tesi sile fun ti ibawi na mu jade.
In Hebrews chapter 12 now verse 6.
Ebe rori kejila ba yese ikefa.
For whom the Lord loves, he chastiseth and scourgeth every son whom he receiveth.
Nitori pe eni ti Oluwa fe
many of us, we have children at home. Why do we discipline our children? Why do we correct them and tell them, no, you can't go that way, no, you can't say that, no, you can't be doing that now? Why do we do that?
Well,
we want that child to realize that we want him to grow up in a very good way and to have good manners that will befit the family that he belongs to. And when we see him deviating from the path of rectitude and righteousness, uprightness, we say, no, we frown at that. We say, you cannot do that.
It's
because of our love for our children. It's the same thing. It's the love of God for us that makes him to correct us whenever we're going astray. Number one, he wants to show his displeasure to our sin. He's a holy God. He wants us to be holy. He wants us to fit into the life pattern of his holy family. And whenever any of us will go astray and do anything different, he shows his displeasure against our sin. Number two, that discipline, that chastisement is to alert us to the danger of sin. Because, you know, if you do something wrong and nobody talks, if you go the wrong way and the Lord does not chastise you, you might not realize that you are going the wrong way, and eventually sin will multiply and sin will increase and destroy your life. Number three, it is to restrain us from repeating that sin. One a child, a young child, when he does something and then you rebuke that child, or you might even beat that child, you restrain that child from repeating that same thing because it's evil.
Number 4,
it is to prevent something more terrible from happening to us. And number 5, it is to make us to be partakers of his holiness.
And
look at verse 7. If ye endure chastening, God dealeth with you as with sons.
He's
not dealing with you as an enemy. You see, there are some people, and it is because we do not know the scriptures, or it's because we knew it before and we are forgetting. Whenever there is divine rebuke and divine chastisement, we feel that the person rebuking us, used as an instrument of God to chastise us, he becomes an enemy. And even God now, we're looking at God far away. It's like God is an enemy now. No, God is our Father, and it is because he's showing his love, he's dealing with you as with children in the family.
Lati ba wa wi lati to wa sona ohun to ma nje iwa wa ni opo igba ni pe irinse ti olorun lo gege bi ohun elo lati ba wa wi
For what son is he whom the father chastiseth not? Verse 8, but if he be without chastisement, whereof all, underline the word all are partakers, then are ye bastards and not sons. He tells us then that chastisement, discipline, correction, rebuke is something normal, is something that should go on in the family of God. Because we are members of his family, he wants us to be partakers of his holiness. We go to number two now.
He
is giving us something practical.
He
is telling us for something we already know in our own families.
It
reminds us that when we were young and we were children, under the leadership and under the control of our fathers and mothers, we were rebuked, we were chastised, we were disciplined, because that is part of a normal life in a normal family. He now gives us parental example of discipline. He says, furthermore, we have had fathers of our flesh which corrected us, and we gave them reverence.
Oni pelu pelu awa ni baba wa ni patiara ti on to wa awa si nbu ola fun won.
He says, shall we not much rather be in subjection unto the father of spirits and live?
O wa so wi pe awa ki yo kuku teriba.
He said, for verily they, for a few days, they chastened us after their own pleasure.
He's
telling us about what should happen normally in a good family. And every father here, every mother here should know the importance of the discipline of children in their families. Obviously, within children, and you know that the rod of correction in the family may not bring immediate joy to the child.
Daju daju pelu awon omode opa ibawita na si won nigba ti an ba won wi o le momu ayo wa lesekese.
But a disciplined child will have joy from that discipline eventually.
Sugbon omo ti to ba gba ibawi
But children who run away from discipline and they refuse discipline early in life, they will never grow up to be useful men and women later in life. Actually, discipline educates children. In your own family, educate your children, train your children, discipline them when they need discipline. There are some principles of life, standards of better living, that the children will never learn very well except the parents will give them correction.
There are
Think about it even in the school. At school, children will not learn some subject that they regard as very difficult if there is total absence of all forms of discipline. What they know in theory, they will not be able to really know in practice if they do not have real correction confusion and discipline.
Ohun ti ba mo ninu opolo lasan won o ni le mo ninu igwa tabi ninu ise won to ba je pe won o ni ibawi rara.
We learn a great deal in school, we learn a great deal in life because of the corrections and the disciplines we receive.
Opolopo eko la mo nko ni ile iwe be ni opolopo eko la mo ri ko ninu aye nitori pe a ri ibawi ninu aye wa.
Let's look at the scriptures, what the scriptures have to say concerning discipline in the family.
Eje ki a wo iwe mimo bayi ki a wo nkan to ni so fun wa nipa ibawi ninu ebi.
This is talking about the natural family now.
Elewa so nipa ebi itara bayi.
And if you are a parent, you must manifest this kind of discipline in your family.
Ti o ba je obi lawujo wa yi, o gbodo fi ru ibawi bayi han ninu ebi.
In Proverbs chapter 13.
Owe ori ketala.
Proverbs chapter 13.
Owe ori ketala.
Verse 24.
Ese ikerin lelogo.
He that spareth his rod hateth his son.
Ẹni tí ó bá fa ọwọ́ pàṣà sẹ́yìn, ó kórìíra ọmọ rẹ̀.
But he that loveth him chasteneth him betimes.
Ṣùgbọ́n ẹni tí ó fẹ́ a máa tètè ná.
There should be discipline in our natural human family.
Ìbáwí gbọ́dọ̀ wà nínú ẹbí wa nípa tara.
In Proverbs chapter 19.
Òwe orí kọkàndínlógún.
And in verse 18.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkejìdínlógún.
Chasten thy son while there is hope, and let not thy soul spare for his crying.
Na omo re nigba ti ireti wa ma si se gbe okan re le ati pa.
Young people, children need discipline, they need correction, they need rebuke. Therefore, don't just be laughing all the time. When your children need the discipline, give it to them.
Awon odo awon omo kekeke won yi won nilo ibawi. Nítorí náà, má ṣe pé nígbà gbogbo kó o máa rẹ́rìn sí wọn tí a bá nílò ìbáwí bá wọn wí.
In Proverbs chapter 22 verse 15.
Òwe orí kejìlélógún ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹẹ̀dógún.
Foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, but the rod of correction shall drive it from him.
Ní àyà ọmọdé ni wèrèdì sí. Ṣùgbọ́n pàṣán ìtọ́ni ni yóò lé jìnà kúrò lọ́dọ̀ rẹ̀.
You see, there are times that young people will do things that are foolish, things that are improper, and it is when you bring that correction, it's the rod of correction that will drive that foolishness far away from the child.
Ó jẹ́ mọ̀ pé àwọn ọ̀dọ́ ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìgbà máa wà tí wọ́n máa ń hùwà bí wèrè, tí wọ́n á hùwà aláìgbọ́n. Nígbà tí ó bá wá na pàṣán ìbáwí sí irú ọmọ bẹ́ẹ̀, irú pàṣán ìbáwí ni ó lé wèrè kúrò nínú ọkàn rẹ̀.
Proverbs chapter 23 verse 13.
Òwe orí kẹtàlélógún ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹtàlá.
Withhold not correction from the child, for if thou beatest him with the rod, he shall not die.
Má ṣe fa ọwọ́ ìbáwí sẹ́yìn kúrò lára ọmọdé. Nítorí pé bí ìwọ bá fi pàṣán ná, òun kì yóò kú.
Thou shalt beat him with the rod and shall deliver his soul from hell.
Ìwọ fi pàṣán ná, ìwọ sì gba ọkàn rẹ̀ là kúrò ní ọ̀run àpáàdì.
Proverbs chapter 29.
Òwe orí kọkàndínlọ́gbọ̀n.
And in verse 15.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹẹ̀dógún.
The rod and reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself bringeth his mother to shame.
Pàṣán àti ìbáwí fúnni ní ọgbọ́n. Ṣùgbọ́n ọmọ tí a bá jọ̀wọ́ rẹ̀ fún ara rẹ̀ á dójú ti ìyá rẹ̀.
That means a child that you always leave to do whatever he wants anytime he wants to do it, and there's never correction, there's never a rebuke, that child is going to bring the family to shame.
Ìyẹn ni pé ọmọ tó jọ̀wọ́ sí tó jẹ́ pé o ti kẹ́ bàjẹ́ o fi sáàyè ara rẹ̀. In tó bá fẹ́ ṣe yóò ṣe ní àkókò tó bá wù. Irú ọmọ bẹ́ẹ̀ á mú dójú ti ẹbí tí ó di ẹbí rẹ̀ gan.
In verse 17, correct thy son, and he shall give thee rest, yea, he shall give thee delight unto thy soul.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹtàdínlógún tọ́ ọmọ rẹ yóò sì fún ọ nísinmi, yóò sì fi inú dídùn sí ọ lé ọkàn.
In Job chapter 6.
Job orí kẹfà.
Job chapter 6.
Job orí kẹfà.
In verse 24.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹrìnlélógún.
Teach me and I will hold my tongue. Cause me to understand wherein I have erred.
Ẹ̀kọ́ mi, èmi ò sì pa ẹnu mi mọ́. Kíyèsí mú mi mòye ibi tí mo gbé ti sìn náà.
That's the purpose of discipline in the family.
Ète ìbáwí nínú ẹbí ni eléyìí o.
You are teaching that child, you are teaching that young fellow, and you are making him to understand where he has committed error, where he has erred.
Òǹkọ́ ọmọ yìí, bẹ́ẹ̀ ló ń báwí, ó sì ń ṣe ìtọ́ni rẹ̀. lati je ko ni oye ibi to ti sina ni ibi to ti saserege.
So the apostle brings a practical example, a practical illustration of what happens in the natural family, and he applies it into the family of God, into the church.
Nitori na apostle wa mo to sele ninu ebi ti afojuri iyan ninu ebi itara.
We now come to Hebrews chapter 12 again. And he's telling us there is a profit in discipline. There is profit for that individual who will endure that discipline, who will accept that discipline, who will know it is a rod of the Lord upon his life, and he hears that rod, and he knows who has appointed the rod.
The
brings us to point three now, the prophet in divine discipline. Hebrews chapter 12 verse
10.
For they verily referring to our human parents, they verily for a few days chastened us after their own pleasure, but he, referring to God, for our profit, that we might be partakers of his holiness.
Nitori won to so ni o so nipa ebi wa nipa tara won to wa fun ojo die bi o ti dara loju won sugbon ohun o wa so nipa olorun bayi.
It is for our profit that we might be partakers of his holiness. Always understand, whenever the Lord is rebuking us for anything, it is for our good. It is that we will be partakers of his holy nature.
Olorun se leyi fun ere wa ati pe ki a le je alabapin ninu iwa mimo re.
In verse 11 now, no chastening for the present seemeth to be joyous but grievous, nevertheless afterward after the discipline, afterward after enduring it, afterward after yielding and surrendering under it, afterward it yieldeth the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby.
Ese kokanla o ni gbogbo ibawi ko dabi ohun ayo nisisin yi bi ko se ibanuje sugbon nikeyin iyan ni pe nikeyin ti a ba farada iponju yan ati ibawi nikeyin ti a ba ni iwa rere ninu ibawi na nikeyin re aso esu alafia.
You see here, what the Lord is telling us is that even though correction may not be something that makes us happy, makes us get excited, and makes us feel like jumping up and laughing, it says it may not bring immediate joy now, it may even be grievous, but nevertheless, at the end, after you have endured it, it will bring the peaceable fruit of righteousness.
O le modun mo wa ninu ni akoko ibawi na ibawi ti e le fa inira ba aye wa sugbon wa so pe leyin ibawi ti a ba farada a wa so esu alaafia fun awon ti ato nipa re.
But he's saying that it will only bring forth fruit to them which are exercised thereby.
O ni esu yi yo wa sodu awon to je pe ato nipa re.
That is, the people after receiving that discipline, they examine themselves.
Iyan ni pe awon to je pe ta ba bawi bayi won wa wa di aye won.
They discovered the reason for which the Lord was rebuking them. They go to the fountain of the blood of the Lamb so they can be cleansed all over again. They reconsecrate their lives unto the Lord as a result of that rebuke, and they say, Lord, I understand you are dealing with me as a child, you are dealing with me as a member of the family, I reconsecrate my life unto you.
Olorun lekan si wa ni Oluwa Oyeye mi nigba na idi ti o se nba mi wi ti o se nto mi sona nisisin mo wa fi aye meji fun lekan si.
As a result of this, he now gives us counseling.
Nipa ele lo wa fun ani oro iyanju.
If we are going to have any profit from the rebuke or from the discipline,
bi awa yo ba ni ere tabi ta orere gba ninu ibawi na.
He says in verse 12, wherefore lift up the hands which hang down.
Ni ese ikejila oni nitori na eno wo ti o ro.
And the feeble knees.
Ase ekun ailera.
You know what he's telling us here? He said, if you have been under the rebuke of the Lord and you are fainting and you are getting into despair or despondency and already discouragement is setting in, you are becoming double minded, you are becoming depressed or dejected, or it is like the devil is telling you to desert the Lord. He said, no, that's not how to profit in the discipline. He said, lift up the hands which hang down. He said, and the feeble knees, strengthen the feeble knees and begin to pray. He says in verse 13, make straight paths for your feet. Don't allow yourself to be wobbling, to be undecided because of the discipline. He said you need to make straight path for your feet, lest that which is lame be turned out of the way. But he said, but let it rather be healed. Your sick spiritually, let it rather be healed. Your mind, your soul is not in the right place with the Lord, let it rather be healed. You know, we need to make it very, very clear. We're talking about divine discipline. We know the Lord can use a human being, a human instrument to bring the discipline. But we who are leaders in the church ought to be very, very careful. And before you discipline somebody in the district or in any locality, ask yourself, will God discipline this person as a result of this thing that he has done? We must not be stricter than God. We cannot have a higher standard, a greater standard than God. Neither the pastor, nor the coordinator, nor the whole church, nor a whole denomination should have a higher standard than Almighty God. The standard of God is high enough already.
Tabi eleya meya kan a o gbodo ni osunwon to gaju to Olorun lo osunwon Olorun yen ti ga to.
If you discipline somebody for something that God will not discipline that person for, it means you are raising yourself above God. It means you are telling God the standard of God is not high enough. You must add your own idea, you must add your own temperament, and you must add your own method to correct God, that God is not strict enough, therefore you need to teach God what it means to be strict.
Nigba ki igba to ba nba eniyan wi koja nti Olorun le ba wi fun ni iru akoko be o so fun Olorun wi pe Olorun odiwon ibani wi re yi ti rele ju mo ti wa ni odiwon kan nipa iwa re nipa ise re ti o se ye wa fi han fun Olorun pe mo ni osunwon to gaju to Olorun lo.
And when you do that, it means that you yourself will get into trouble with God, and he himself will bring a greater punishment and a greater judgment and discipline upon you.
Nigba to ba wa uri iwa ba iyen ni pe o wonu la si gbo pelu Olorun niyan Olorun fun ara re awa mu ijiya to gaju yen lo wa sori iwo na.
But we know there is divine discipline,
sugba wa mo pe ibawi Olorun nbe.
And if God is going to use you at all in that as an instrument, you need to be very, very careful. Because if you go beyond what the Lord wants you to do, you need to remember Moses. The children of Israel were not doing well at all. And in fact, those children of Israel, they needed rebuke, they needed correction, but the Lord said, give them water to drink.
Nigba ki igba ti o ba fe ba ni wi o je ya ran ti ki ipele to fe gbe kale lati ba ni wi ko ma ba gaju to Olorun lo o ya ran ti Mose eni to je pe awon omo Israeli nigba ti won se nkan kan to ye ko n ba won wi fun olorun mo bo se le ba won wi sugba niru akoko yen olorun ni omi lasan ni ko fun won.
The people, they said, we don't have any water to drink.
Awon eyan yen ni ko so mi fun wa lati mu.
And so they began to grumble.
Won ba bere si kun.
And Moses went to God.
Mose to olorun lo.
Because he knew that's the family of God, every decision we take about the family of God, about any member of the family, God should take that decision. Whether it is rebuke or correction or discipline, God should take the decision.
Nitori pe oyeye wi pe ebi Olorun niyan nigba ki igba ti ebi Olorun ba nilo itoni tabi ibawi Olorun lo ye ko yan ipinu na boya itoni ni o boya ibawi ni o boya ifiyaje ni ni o Olorun ye ko yan ikan ninu re.
And so God said, this time Moses, just take the rod in your hand and go and speak to the rock and give them water to drink.
Olorun wa so fun Mose pe lakoko yin ti wa se ni pe mu opa re lowo re lo soro si apata na ko si fun won lomi lati mu.
And Moses was surprised that God did not have a word of rebuke, a word of correction for these rebellious people, and he just said, don't talk to them, don't say anything to them. What I want to do now is just to give them water to drink.
Olorun o wa nwo Olorun bayi pe ni iru akoko bayi se iwo Olorun o wa ni ni oro ibawi kankan fun awon lo ti Olorun lile won yi ni se pe nkan wa ba won soro pe kin wa fun olomi lati mu lasan so to ge.
And so Moses, he forgot himself. He raised his own standard above the standard of God. He struck the rock 2 times. Water came out. He said, you rebels, must we bring water out of the rock for you to come and drink? Come and drink now, you people who are just serving God for bread and butter.
Ni akoko yi Mose wa gbagbe ara re o wa lo sibi apata na o lu apata le meji omi si jade o ni so mi le yin Olorun lile yi eyin o lo te lele fe mu mi omi ni e wa mo mu eyin to je pe nitori akara to nje le sinsin Olorun.
And then God called him and said, Moses, did I tell you to rebuke them? Did I say you should be an instrument or a rod of correction at this time? Isn't it just what I told you to give them? How is it you went and you added to what I said? That land of Canaan, Moses, you will not get there.
Ni akoko na Olorun wa so fun Mose pe Mose se mo ni ko je opa eba wi fun ile Israel ni ki se a se pe mo so fun e pe ko kan fun won lomi lati mu ni.
Let's be very, very careful. Don't get to the point that every time you are carrying a rod, every time you must rebuke somebody, every time you must challenge somebody, every time you must put somebody down, you can go too far and you may lose your life for
it. Ese die tabi nkan kan die te ba se bayi opa ibawi tin be lowo re ma se se be ko wa koja ala re lodo lodumare.
But we know that the lesson the Lord is teaching us is that when we go wrong as children of God, he loves us and he will rebuke us, but he will rebuke us at the measure, at the limit of what we have done wrong. And once we correct that sin, he receives us as his own children, because the purpose behind, or the reason behind that discipline, is the love of God.
E wa je ka mo ile igbangba gege bi omo Olorun wi pe nigba ki igba ti a ba se ohunkohun to ba lodi Olorun a ba wa wi Olorun a to wa si ona a si fun wa ni ibawi to ba ye fun odi won nkan ti a se ni iru akoko be nitori ko tin fi se le ni pe o ni ife si wa o si nto wa.
In Psalm 119 verse 71.
Orin Dafidi orin kokande ni 100 ese kokande logorin.
Psalm 119 verse 71.
Orin Dafidi ikokande logorin.
It is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes.
Ese kokan le laadorin o dara fun mi ti a pon mi loju ki emi ki o le ko ilana re.
You see the purpose there, you see the profit there. We are rebuked, we are chastised, that we might learn the judgment and the statutes and the commandments of the law.
O ti ri le pa na eti Olorun ni to fi n ba wa wi ninu ese ti akayi o na ni pe ki awa ki o le ko ilana ati awon eko Olorun.
And then in Isaiah chapter 26.
Isaiah ori keji kerinde ni ogbon.
Isaiah 26, we see the purpose of God in bringing rebuke or discipline.
Isaiah ori kerinde ni ogbon nibe lati ri ete ati ipinu Olorun lati mu ibawi wa sori
iwa. Let me first of all read verse 10 and verse 16 before I come back to verse verse 9. Let favor be showed to the wicked, yet will he not learn righteousness. In the land of uprightness, he will deal unjustly, he will not behold the majesty of the Lord. You know, in a church where there is no correction and we're only smiling with one another, we do not correct the people that are wrong. Let favor be shown unto the wicked, he will not learn righteousness. But in verse 16, Lord, in trouble have they visited thee. They poured out a prayer when thy chastening was upon
them.
You see, when the correction comes, when the discipline comes, it leads them to prayer. It makes them actually better. It makes them to have all the grace of God in their lives and to become partakers of righteousness. Now in verse 9, with my soul have I desired thee in the night, yea, with my spirit within me will I seek thee early. For when thy judgments are in the earth, the inhabitants of the world will learn righteousness.
Pẹ̀lú ẹ̀mí mi nínú mi lè èmi ó wà ní kùtùkùtù nítorí nígbà tí ìdájọ́ rẹ ń bẹ ní ilẹ̀.
That's the reason for discipline. That's the reason for correction. When thy judgments are in the earth, the inhabitants of the world will learn righteousness. In 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10.
1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10.
But the God of all grace, who has called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while the discipline, ye have suffered a while the rebuke, after that make you perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you.
Ni ese ikewa olorun ori ofe gbogbo ti o ti pe yin sinu ogo re ti ko ni ipekun ninu Kristi Jesu nigba ti eyin ba ti jiya die ninu ibawi nigba ti eyin ba ti jiya die ninu itonisona o ni ohun ti kara re yo si se yin le ase pe yo fi ese yin mule yo fun yin ni agbara yo si fi idi yin kale.
It's for a while, it's not supposed to be for eternity, for a very long time, for a while. And once we learn what he wants us to learn, he establishes us, he strengthens us, he settles us in the family again.
O gbodo wa fun igba die ko gbodo wa fun gbere titi aye o gbodo wa fun igba die ni nigba ti a ba ti wa ko eko to fe ka kon ninu re a wa se wa la se pe a fese wa mule a fun wa lagbara a wa fi idi wa kale ninu ebi re.
But the Lord does everything because he loves us.
Sori pe Olorun fe wa o si fe on gbogbo.
A wonder of wonders that he loves us so much.
Iyanu na si ni pe Olorun fe wa lopolopo.
He will not allow you to go astray.
Ko ni faye gbo lati sina.
He has a place for you in heaven.
O ni ibi kan to kuke se
Olorun. He has saved you already and you are part of the family of God.
O ti gba lana ara ebi Olorun ni o.
And if you do anything wrong, and if you go into sin, instead of just leaving you to yourself, who is thinking, who will be in that mansion he has prepared for you? Who will be in that fellowship he wants you to be with him? He says, I will get after him, I will search after him, whatever I need to do. If I need to chastise him a little, I need to correct him a little, so that I can bring him back, I cannot miss sees him in heaven, he must be in heaven. That's the reason why God is chastising you. That's the reason why he disciplines you. It's because of his love and that heaven that he has prepared for you. He does not want you to miss. You will not miss it in Jesus' name.
Ibikibi ti Olorun ba fe lo ni yo lo de lati ri pe o ba owi tabi o to sona lati le pa omo ko ba le je pe Olorun ninu ero re ile ati idapo to ti pese sile fun e ko be ko padanu re idi niyan ti Olorun fi na pase ibawi lati fi to e sona
thank God for his love
padanu re adupe Olorun fun ife
thank God for his mercy
adupe Olorun fun anu re
thank God for his determination that you must get to heaven
dupe Olorun pe ipinu re pe o gbodo gbe Olorun
and you will get there
wa si debe
you will get there
ani wa debe
the blood of Jesus is available to wash and cleanse you
eje Jesu nbe laro wo to
the word of God is there to correct you. And the Lord will do everything that he needs to do to get you there. Rise up and tell the Lord, I appreciate your love for me. I know you do not want me to perish. Oh Lord, whatever you need to do, do it in my life so I will get to that heaven. If I need correction, give it to me. If I need rebuke, give it to me. If I need chastisement, give it to me. If I need discipline, give it to me. You can talk to me directly. You can use my fellow brother, my fellow sister. You can use members in the church. You can use leaders in the church. Oh Lord, correct me. Don't leave me in my own way. Whatever will not allow me to get to heaven, take it away from my life. Use every method that is necessary so that I will become a partaker of your holiness.